Good morning, students. Today our topic is Python programming, in which we are going to discuss about conditional statement. We already discussed if statement in our previous lecture, and in this lecture we are going to discuss about if else statement. So let's start. If else statement. As you know that in if statement, if the condition is true, only then the statement that relate to that condition will be executed, otherwise no statement will be executed. And if the condition is false, then nothing will be executed regarding to that conditions. So statement will only execute if condition will be true, otherwise no other statement will be executed regarding to that condition. Now if else statement, as the name suggests, if else, so statement, certain statement will definitely be executed. And why? It is because if condition is true, then the statement that relate to the if will be executed, and if the condition is false, then statement that relate to else will be executed. So we will discuss it in detail. First of all, the if statement is similar to the if statement, except that the fact if also provides a block of the code for the false case of the condition to be checked. And if the condition provided in the if statement is false, then the else statement will be executed. Here one thing is very important, that we don't provide any condition in else statement. We provide only a condition in if statement. And if this condition is true, then the statement related to the condition will be executed. And if it is false, then the statement related to the else will be executed. It means the execution of the statement only depends upon the condition, whether the condition is true or whether the condition is false. So again, the if else statement, there are some points regarding to if else statement. Okay. The if statement provides an else block combined with the if statement, which is executed in the false case of the condition, and if the condition is true, then the if block is executed, otherwise the else block is executed. So second point is very important. If the condition is true, here there is a condition, and this condition is attached with the if statement, and there are only two possibilities. It may be true or it may be false. But if the condition is true, then the if block is executed, otherwise else block is executed. Let us see its flow chart again. Here you can easily see that there is a condition and there are two possibilities. Condition may be false or condition may be true. There is no other possibility except that the condition may be true or may be false. There are two possibilities. If condition is true, then the statement related to that condition, it means if block, condition attached with the if block will definitely be executed. And if condition is false, then the statement attached with the else block will definitely be executed. It means certain statement will definitely be executed. It is not like as we found in if statement, that if the condition is false, then nothing will be executed at all. But if else cover those shortcoming which provide by if statement. So if condition is true, then the statement related to the if block will be executed, and if condition is false, then the statement that related to the else block will be executed definitely. So something will be executed definitely. We will very sure about this. So that is the main advantage of the if else statement, that condition may be true or condition may be false. If condition is true, then the if block will be executed, or if condition is false, then else block will be executed. So we have two options: either the statement of the if block will be executed or else block will be executed. So that is the main advantage of the if else statement. For example, in our last lecture when we discussed about the if statement, then there is a program, suppose to find out a positive number. And we give a condition that if a number is greater than 0, then it may be positive. It will definitely be positive. And we write a print statement regarding to that, that a number is positive. But what happens if number is negative? Suppose if number is less than 0, then nothing will be executed because no statement attached to that condition. But if else statement, if else clause of the Python programming covers this main drawback. And what happens when we give a condition in if statement that number is greater than 0, then number is positive, and provide a statement with else clause and just write that number is negative or it may be 0. So that if number is not positive, it will definitely be 0. That means else statement will definitely be executed. I think now it's time to show its syntax. So it is the syntax as appear on a screen. That is the syntax. It will give you full and clear idea about how if at statement, what is the syntax of if else statement. Here you can easily see that if, first of all, we write if, then after we write a condition, there is any condition regarding to the if statement, condition may be true or it may be false, and after that we provide a sign of colon. That is the syntax of if statement. And in the next line, after giving some space, that is also called the indentation, we provide a statement or a block of a statement. That means they will be executed only if the condition is true. And what happens if the condition is false? Then after that, we can easily see that we just write else, E-L-S-E, else, and after that, put a colon sign and remember that there is no condition at all. And why it is so? It is because we have only one condition and we have two possibilities. Either the condition is true or either the condition is false. If the condition is true, then the block of statement will be executed. And if the condition is not true, then the statement related to the else will definitely be executed. It means just write with an else statement, then another block of statement, else block. This block will definitely be executed. It means something will definitely be printed or executed on a screen. And there is no possibility that the condition is false, then nothing will happen. So at least certain calculation will be there, or certain print statement will be there. We write as a print statement in else clause, which is executed when the condition is false. So that is the main advantage of if else condition, if else block, if else condition statement. So we just provide a condition with keyword, and this condition may be true or false. If the condition is true, then the statement attached to the keyword will be executed, and if it is false, then the statement that are related to the else will definitely be executed. So that is the main advantage of if else block, and that which is not provided by only if statement. So this is the syntax of if condition, if else condition. Now it's time to make a program. Here you can see that there is a small program which illustrates the functioning of if else block, and this is a program to check whether a person is eligible to vote or not. So we write a program here which checks whether a person is eligible to vote or not, and we just know the condition about the voting criteria, and the condition is very simple. If the age is greater than 18, then a person is eligible to vote, and if the age is less than 18, then the person is not eligible to vote. So the condition is very very much clear for us. So now here one thing is important, and the important is the age. So age is a variable name. So first of all, we declared as a age. So here we take a variable name age and just provide input statement for that, and just write int input enter your age. So what happens after the execution of that statement? Computer asks for input your age. Just there is a message, enter your age, and we provide an age to it. And after that, there is a if statement, and we just type if age is greater than or equal to 80. So it will check that whether the age is greater than or equal to 18. It may be greater than or equal to 18, or it may not be. So if it age is greater than or equal to 18, then there is a print statement attached with the if clause, and that is written here, print you are eligible to vote. So there is a print statement that you are eligible to vote will definitely be print on your screen if the age is greater than or equal to 18. And remember that after giving the condition, always put the colon sign. You can easily see here, if age is greater than or equal to 18, after that colon, and the statement which are related to that condition must be given after indentation. So you can see that print you are eligible to vote. And next is else print sorry, you have to wait. And there is the else statement attached to it. And if this condition is not true, it means if age is less than 18, remember that we don't provide any condition with else clause. So here print sorry, you have to vote will definitely be printed on a screen whenever age is less than 18. So when age is greater than or equal to 18, there is a statement you are eligible to vote, and when age is less than 18, then sorry, you have to wait, this statement will be printed on a screen. So there are two statements, and the concept is very clear. Condition may be true or may be false giving with if statement. If the condition is true, then the statement related to the if block will be executed, otherwise statement related to the else block will be executed. And remember that we provide no condition for else statement. There is no condition for else statement. Else means just simply if condition provided with if block is not true, or it may be, or it becomes false, then all the statement related to else block will be executed. Here there is only single statement, so just either on a screen there is a statement you are eligible to vote will be printed, or sorry you have to vote will be printed. So there are only two options at all. So either the first statement you are eligible to vote will be printed, or you have to vote you have sorry you have to vote wait this statement will be printed. It's depend upon what it depend only upon that we provide what output for that age variable. So first of all, when we execute this program, there is a message enter your age. And why this message appears? Because we provide an input for the age variable, and we provide an age, and it may be less than 18 or greater than 18. There is only two possibilities, and Python checks whether the age is greater than 18. There is a conditional statement. If this conditional statement becomes true, then you are eligible to vote will be printed on the screen. And if this statement is false, then sorry you have to vote will be printed on the screen. So there are only two possibilities only, and there is no other third possibilities. If there may be a third possibility, then which is not in this case, then the statement attached with the else will definitely be executed whenever the condition may be whenever we found the condition is false. So remember one thing, if the condition is false, then the statement related to the else clause will definitely be executed. That is the main concept of if else statement. So now I think it is clear to all of you, and you provide a condition in your Python programming with if statement, and it may be true or false. If it is true, then the statement related to the if will be executed, and if it is false, then the statement related to the else will be executed. Here one thing should be noticed that there is only single statement, and if there are more than a statement, then we provide a block to the if or else clause. Or else, as we provide in a case of if statement in our previous lecture. So there is a single statement, and you provide a more than one statement. So if you want to provide more than one statement, remember that indentation is same for all of them. If indentation is different, then there is an error, or the program output will appear in different way. So now I think the concept is clear to all of you. And you make any program regarding to that, just give any condition with if clause. And second important thing is that there are relational operator which are used to show the condition, and these are less than, greater than, less than, equal to, greater than, equal to. So these are the relational operator, or we can say that the comparison operator, which are used to give or to provide a condition. And this topic relational operator or
comparison operator are already discussed in our previous lecture, where we discuss operators in detail. So so if you want to execute a conditional statement program, so you should have a good knowledge of comparison operator, because every time you need comparison operator. And second important thing is that if there are more than one condition, then concept is very simple. Just separate it with AND or operator. And these are the logical operator, as we know. If the we can separate it with AND or. If we want to provide a choice between them, then we just write OR in between two conditions. And if we don't provide a choice between them, then we just write AND between them. Then we can write AND between them. So if we want to separate two conditions, we have two choice. First choice is either we have to write OR we have to write AND. And this topic is already discussed in if statement in our last lecture. So here our focus is only to how to implement if else statement and how it is different from only if statement. So that is our focus, or that is our motive. Now one more thing is very important. If we want to make this program only if statement, then what happens? Then here we just write if age is greater than 18, print you are eligible to vote. That's okay for us. But if you want to print sorry you have to vote, then we write again and condition if age is less than equal to 18. So there are two if statements, and in that case sorry you have to wait will be printed. So as far as comparison is concerned between if else statement and if statement, there is a very simple difference between these two. And the difference is that in if statement, where suppose we have four conditions, then we have to write four if statements. But in if else statement, we just write is particular condition, and this condition may be true or may be false. If it is true, then all the statement related to the if will be executed, and if it is false, then the statement that related to the else will definitely be executed. So don't write condition again and again. So for our simplicity, we just write if age is greater than 18, and then print you are eligible to vote, and else print sorry you have to vote. Wait, that is another statement. But if this program we want to make with if statement, then where we write else, we have to write if age is less than equal to 18. So the main advantage of if else statement over if is that we have to provide only one condition at a time. And condition may be true or condition may be false, and we don't write any condition with else clause. This is very very important, and I repeat it only two or three times here. And why I repeat this statement again and again? Because there is a main advantage of the if else statement, that the condition, if the condition is false, then the statement attached to the else will definitely be executed in our program. So that is the main advantage of if else statement. Now I think the concept is quite clear to all of you. So to execute a statement related to if and else, as far as practical portion is concerned, you have to remember two or three important things. First of always put colon sign after if and after else. Second thing, you must provide a condition with must provide a statement with if or else statement. And when we provide a statement attached to if and else statement, just give proper indentation or proper after given proper space. And if there are more than one statement attached to it, then make a proper block for that. And how to make a block or give proper indentation, this topic is discussed in detail in our previous lecture. So you have to follow this lecture, otherwise this concept you will not get the concept of if else clause. Now let us execute this program. Just go to Python IDLE, integrated development language environment, where we write execute our program. That's why it is called the integrated development language environment. And just try it. This is interactive mode appears first. but we have to write program in script mode. So just go to script mode and go to new file. Here we can write a program, our program. This is our program here. You have to write a program here. To save our time, I just perform copy and paste operation here and then save the file, and after that give the file name, filename.py. py is the extension for Python, so let's provide a name here and just save the program, and here you can see the output. Enter your age. Now here I provide age, suppose 15. So the message is sorry, you have to wait. It means a statement related to else will be executed in that case. Now again, if I want to execute this program and provide a age, enter age, and age is 45, suppose, then there is a message, you are too eligible to vote. So that is a output of that program. So for each possibility, enter age. Suppose I put age -5, it is actually not possible that age is -5, and sorry, you have to wait, will be printed. Here intentionally I provide an age -. It simply means that in Python programming have no idea about the data which we enter. It only executes the data what we provide to it, and it basically execute the statement according to the data. I know that -5 is invalid age, but the main point is that condition will be checked that the age is greater than 18 or not. If the age is less than 18, whether it is 0, whether it is negative, whether it has some meaning or it has no meaning at all, the statement that relate to else will be definitely executed. That is our main concern, and that is the main point regarding to that. It doesn't mean that it has a sense or not. It has another thing, but the main focus, but the main thing regarding to if else statement is that whenever the condition is false, then the statement related to the else will be definitely be executed, whether it has a certain meaning or sense or not. As in this case, -5, we already know that -5 age is not possible at all, but since the a condition is false, so the statement related to the else clause will definitely be executed. Now enter your age. Again execute this program, and here we want just 0, then again there is a message, sorry, you have to wait. And this statement is executed again and again whenever the condition becomes false. Now let us make another program related to the if else statement, and this program is program number 2 for you, and this is a program to check whether his number is even or not. And what is the condition to check even or not? There is a simple condition to check even or not. If we divide a number by 2 and we find remainder 0, then it will definitely be an even number, otherwise it is an odd number. So for remainder, we apply your operator modulo division. So the condition here is if num modulo 2 equal to 0, there is a condition. And when you found a condition, then program is very simple for us. So first of all, this is the program. Can see here, first of all give a variable name num and just write input statement for that, int input enter the number. So a message will appear on a screen after the execution of that program that enter the number, and we enter any number. It may be divisible by 2 or may not be divisible by 2. And then in second line, we just write if num modulo 2 is equal to 0. It means we divide a number which we provide to Python programming, and that number may be, when we divide it by 2, then the remainder may be 0, may not be 0. But the condition here is number modulo 2 equal to 0. It means if the condition, if the remainder is 0, then what happens? Then there is a statement print number is even. And if the number modulo 2 is not 0, whatever it is, it may be 1 or it may be 0. Actually, there is only two possibility. When we divide a number by 2, then either the remainder will be 0 or either the remainder will be 1. Suppose number is 3, and when we divide 3 by 2, then the remainder is 1. And when we divide 4, then the remainder is again 0, 0. And when we divide 5 by 2, then the remainder is 1. And we, if we divide 6 by 2, then the remainder is 0. So there are only two possibilities. When we divide a number by 2, whether the number is 0 or whether the remainder is 0 or it may be 1. So if it is 0, if the remainder is 0 and we divide a number by 2, then there is a statement number is even. Otherwise, number is odd will be printed. And why it is printed? Because in else clause, we just write a statement print number is odd. So this is a simple program to find whether the number is even or not. I think now it is clear to all of you. And if there are other possibilities, suppose we want to find out that a particular number is divisible by 7 or not. So there are more than one remainder in that case. So again, the concept is very simple, that the statement that relate to the else will definitely execute it. So here, just check this program, that what is the output of this program. Just to go to the script mode of Python programming IDLE. And just write that program here and just execute it. Enter the number here, enter the number 7, and number is odd. And again, execute this program and just rewrite, enter the number, number is 6. Number is even, number 6 or 8, whatever we like, number is even in that case. So even number shows even result and number odd number shows odd result when we execute this program. So this is a program to find out, check whether a number is even or not. We provide simply a number and Python programming basically check it and returns a result whether number is even or not. Here, this is another statement, another program, and this program is here we have to compare two elements and just find out whether the one number is greater than other. So two variables here are 233, and we have to check whether 33 is greater than 200 or not. So A is equal to 200 and B is equal to 33. There are two variables here, and when B, the condition is B is greater than A, it means 33 is greater than A, then the statement B is greater than A will be printed. Otherwise, else statement, that means B is not greater than A, will be printed. So here concept is very simple. As we know that 33 is not greater than 200, so condition is false again in this case. So definitely the statement B is not greater than A will be printed here. So there is only one output, for this program, and this output is B is not greater than A, because condition is false forever, because A and B are fixed for this program. So let us check it here. And just make some changes here to understand this concept very well. Here we just write another statement, add another statement with if, and try to just make a block of this statement by giving proper indentation. And as we can see that there are two statements related to if, and there are two statements related to else as well. And this is called the block of a statement, and these two statements are related to the, here is related to the It is now related to the else statement because no space is there. Here what we provide is space, then now it is both of them makes a block here. So else block two statement, if block also there are two statement here. And we write another statement and just write thanks. Outside the block, it means then it simply means that this statement thanks will always be printed because it has no concern with if block or no concern with else block as well. So this will definitely be executed, and as we can see that there is no space before print statement. So it will definitely be executed with if block or with else block statements. Just write another things. It will say a code. So just write a program over. Program over. Now it's look better. So program over will always be printed. Will always be printed. So now there are two options. First, statement related to the if block will be executed or printed on screen, or else will be printed on screen. But one thing is very clear, the program over statement will definitely be executed on screen or definitely printed on screen because it has no concern with if and else. Let us check it. Give a proper space. Here you can see that space is not there, so indentation is not proper. And when we write enter, so it will automatically provide some space here. You can easily see that. So you need not to write or give a space from another side. Python automatically checks that. Just check it. And if you want to remove, just press backspace key. Now this program is written here. You can easily see that. Just execute this program and just check it. What happens? You can easily see that program over is printed here, and the statement B is not greater than A and 200 is not greater than 33 is printed here. Actually 200 is greater than 33, so but since we write here 200 is greater than is not greater than 33, so it will be executed whether it has a sense or not. It doesn't mean for Python programming because we provide it with else statement and condition is false, so this statement will be executed in that case, and program over will execute it because only because this statement is outside to if else block, both of is if else block completely. So now let's make some change. So this simply means that whatever you write with print statement, it will be executed as it is. Is not greater than 33. So this is here we can say 33 is not greater than 200. So whatever you write within the double quotes and the print statement, that will be printed whether it is a true, whether it has some logic, whether it has some no logic at all. So it doesn't make any sense. Whatever you write, it will be definitely be executed with the print statement. That is I want to say here. And here you can execute this program. Okay, space error is there as they are marked with writing. So provide a space. Okay, then just go to run and then execute this program and execute it. Yes. This is the output. So here, this program, basically I want to show you two things. First of all, block of statement will be executed. Depends on the condition, maybe true or false. And if there is a statement which is not related to the block of statement, then it will be definitely executed. Now shorthand if else statement. So there is a shortcut for writing if else statement also, as a writing if statement, and this is very simple at all. First of all, here this is a small program to define the shorthand if else. You can easily see here a is equal to 2, b is 330, print a if a is greater than b, else print b. So we just write print statement or the statement that depends on the condition first, after that the if, and after that else, and the statement attached with the else. So that is the syntax to execute if else statement in a one line. You can easily see that condition. So a statement will be, we print a statement before if, and after that just write else, and after that statement attached to the else. And that is a shorthand of a else statement. You can check it whether it will be executed successfully or not. You can see here, this is a shorthand of a else statement here. Just execute the program. Okay. That is the output. Now I think the concept is very much clear to all of you. This is all about if else statement. In our next lecture, we will going to discuss about we will definitely discuss about if else statement, and that is another very important concept of conditional statements. So thanks for watching this video.